Do you have hope that you will go home?
How can I hope that? I can't hope that tomorrow morning I will be alive. But I have my grandchildren. I hope one day they will allow to go back there.
Bangladesh shares that dream. It desperately wants to send the Rohingya back. To avoid permanent settlement, the country forbids them from working or sending their kids to school. A temporary island to host refugees is also in the works.
Just to give you an idea how serious the Bangladeshi government is about getting the Rohingya people home, they're literally building a road. It's called the Friendship Highway, and it's going to connect Bangladesh all the way to Myanmar. You'll remember when the Rohingya people came over in that influx, you saw many people coming and falling off boats. That's because they walked for days and then had to take boats across that river. Of course, this road will change all of that. So that is the long-term solution.
In the short term, a refugee island is set to host 100,000 Rohingya. But it's a silt island prone to flooding and cyclones. Aid workers are concerned. The Bangladeshi government promises it will be voluntary. Amina Khatun will not go. She is exhausted by any idea of movement. If sorrow could speak in steps, you'd feel it as you walk beside the 65-year-old. There's a heaviness you just can't ignore.
One of my son, one of my daughter, one of my brother had died, and we couldn't bring them, even their dead bodies.
She tells me how religious leaders and educated members of her society had a target on their back. Her own daughter, slain for being Rohingya.
One of our daughters, she was tortured a lot.
Amina, well into her 60s, is now raising her late daughter's 8 children. It's an emotional and physical toll she fears she cannot sustain.
The most challenging part of my life here is to survive, because there is no one to support me. My husband is aged, and it's really tough for me to make food for all. And whatever we are getting, it's not enough.
What do you want Canadians back home to know about the Rohingya people?
If you want to send us to Myanmar, we don't want to go. I never want to go back in my country in Myanmar, because what I experienced there, I never can forget these things. If you want to send us forcefully, you just kill us here.
Thank you for sharing.